This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about a topic that came up the other day at the Microsoft Security Conference. It was a virtual conference, of course, these days. And Jessica Payne, one of the speakers, talked about legacy systems. And she talked about every business has one, and probably more of them than we want to admit. And if you're very lucky, it's on a virtual machine that can be moved around. And if you're not, it's on some ancient piece of hardware that you hope that will continue to work. That legacy server or workstation that's probably still running an ancient piece of business software that you just can't wean yourself off of. So how do you better protect them? Remember, there's tools like Mimikatz that allow attackers to harvest credentials. So the first thing you need to ask yourself is, are you still logging onto that system with domain administrator credentials? Is there some better way to log onto that system and still maintain it? Often these legacy systems keep hash values of these passwords. And especially if you haven't changed them in a while, heaven forbid, they can be left there for many, many years. Now, if you remember, I've talked about in prior sessions about using the Windows-based firewall to better protect yourself. So you can use things like Wireshark to actually see the actual TCP/IP ports that the application talks out on. Do you need to have full file and printer sharing available on that system? Perhaps you can thin it down to some specific port, and especially talking to some specific server. The entire network doesn't necessarily have to be talking to that machine if the only thing you need is that server talking to that other legacy server over there. So again, determine exactly how the application talks to each other and talks to the workstations in the network that needs it. Can you limit that scope? Can you use the Windows firewall to thin it down? Another tool to analyze your system is PROCMON, or Process Monitor. It's from the sysinternals, and you can download it and review what is exactly going on in that application. If it's a legacy application that needs and demands administrator rights, perhaps you can use tools like Lua BugLight. This is a tool that was provided by Aaron Margosis, also from Microsoft, that allows you to make shims and registry changes in order to process and let the application actually work without admin rights. Using Lua BugLight, you can surgically change permissions on files, directories, registry keys, and other objects in order to make these changes that you need. Next, you'll want to see how the attackers see that machine, and especially if it's a legacy machine, an older machine. There's tools such as Bloodhound. You can download it from GitHub, and allows you to analyze Active Directory. Bloodhound is compiled in several platforms, including Linux, Mac, and Windows. As you can see, there's various different versions that you can download and start to play with. I personally found this article by Adam Bertram to be the easiest to help me set up the environment. And as you can see, Bloodhound allows you to actually see how the attackers visualize your Active Directory infrastructure. It uses graph theory to find the shortest path for an attacker. You want a domain joined machine. I would highly suggest that you set up a virtual machine specifically for this. You download a database tool called Neo4j. The desktop version was the easiest to set up because that has the Java built in, and you didn't have to go download various locations in order to get the Java working. And then you download something called an ingestor called SharpHound that actually goes through and enumerates objects in your domain. Now, do be aware, depending on your network environment, if you have certain antivirus programs on it, it probably will see SharpHound as a threat and block it. I know in my own environment, as you can see, it was blocked because it could harm my device. I actually had to find a Windows 7 machine and download it on that machine, move it over to the network virtual machine in order to get it to where I could run the SharpHound. Once you've run the SharpHound tool, it prepares a zip file that is an analysis of your network. So you launch Bloodhound, it hooks into the database, and you upload your SharpHound resulting zip file. Now in the queries section, you can actually review the common queries that attackers can use against you. You can see some of the interesting ones here: map domain trusts, shortest path to high value targets, list the computers where domain users are local admin, find Kerberos-able members of high value groups, and on and on. You can see how the attackers can use this tool against you once they get a toehold into your network. But of course, you can use the same tool to see how others will see you and better protect yourself from it. If you'd like to dig into more about your network, there's additional resources such as FireEye's Commando virtual machine that is pre-built for penetration testing. Again, you can use a virtual machine. You can also use Docker as well for pen testing platforms. Bottom line, take the time to look to see how you look to attackers. See where your squishy parts are and what can be easily harvested by attackers from these older systems. I know I'll be doing such things as shutting off two-factor RDP on my older systems to ensure that attackers can't harvest credentials from these older machines. So think about, what are you planning to do to protect your legacy systems? Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. I'll see you online at IDG Tech Talk on YouTube.